So length of a putter, I get that one a lot, and it's critical because if the putter is supposed to have the proper lie angle, but if the putter is too long and you stand back, normally the toe goes up in the air. So a lot of people would say, okay, your toe is up, I need to bend it down. No. So number one, setup. If we put a mirror on the ground, a mirror, or put a CD, a disc on the ground, you can see where your eyes are. If you can't even see your eyes because they're so far back, more than likely that toe's going up. So getting the eyes in the proper position, which is the best in the world have it, inside the golf ball. That, just by doing that, loosening your grip and re-gripping it with your eyes in the proper position, then figuring out what your proper length should be. So it's not always the proper thing. When it's too long, it gets upright. Now think of the lie being off. I have 3.5 degrees of loft on this face. And estimated at 20 feet, this is pointing about 8 inches left of your target line. Not because you're aimed there, it's because you have loft on the putter, toes up in the air, and it's aimed left. Same thing. Toes down, first telltale to look for, is a putter too short? I've got 3.5 degrees loft, toe down, putter's aimed this way. Hang on, you're not aimed that way, the putter face is aimed that way from loft. So we just want to get the putter setting right, get your eyes in the right position. And when you do so, it helps the path come right into play. This way too short, normally it goes outside across. This way here, it comes inside to out. When we get it proper eyes, proper lie setting, that stroke becomes much easier to produce and reproduce. So hopefully that answered a few questions. Eyes and length set path. Too upright, you take it outside. Too flat, you bring it inside and go out. Proper lie, proper length, proper putts.